Seth Hodge with 4K Geek here with Colin Young of Luber Imports, and we get to look at incubation.
Yes, we do.
And this is so cute. A little dragons and eggs, you're hatching your dragons, and push your luck kind of game, right?
So this is, in essence, a bit of a push your luck, a bit of a learn to play the market kind of game.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So really what we have here is a first game from Synapse, small little Canadian company we're working with. And they are absolutely wonderful. And what they've done here is they've made a game that was designed to be accessible to the designers' young boys that wanted something fun and easy. The dragons are something to draw the eye.
Yes, for sure.
But also for ease of play with meaningful decisions. So the game, even though it's all about hatching eggs, you're trying to figure out how to collect up dragons, get the most points by the end of play.
Yep.
Play is really going to consist of rolling the two dice each turn, and you have one re-roll, and you can figure out how best to make use of those dice. Are you going to be able to get the fire and the water that you need to
help
grow and hatch and incubate your eggs?
Yes.
Are you going to discard one of your dice in order to get a new card and add it right into your incubator? And that's where you're going to add the resources. And we're going to show that a little bit better over there. You may be able to get coin. This is going to be one of the ways you're going to be able to score points over the course of the game, either by rolling for
it. Because coins are straight up points.
Straight up points.
So,
so that's one way to get points, hatching eggs, or over the course of the game, there are going to be several objective cards available, and those are also going to reward certain types of play depending on what eggs are available.
Yeah.
So overall, what you're going to be doing is throwing the dice, very straightforward rules, but the decisions you're making on how to manipulate that start to evolve from how your board play happens, because you'll notice that on the die you also have the little chest.
Oh yeah.
The chest is going to force you to actually move the board, and whenever the board is moved, you're going to add more
populate
resources.
The board.
Exactly. So you're just going to add those to this
space. How do you claim those?
Whenever you are able to successfully hatch an egg, so you've added the water and the fire necessary to your egg, then you're going to hatch it, you'll be able to flip it over and claim the points for the end of the game, but also the red dragon that you've hatched.
Now we have a red dragon.
It'll be just off of your board to open up the incubator space, but now you're going to be able to take something from, if we had some stuff on a red dragon, as an example right here.
And then I would get yay!
You could choose from there and immediately place them.
If I had no red space?
Then you would end up having to put it right back on the dragon, so there's some timing.
So you want to kind of plan for that.
That's right. So you may be able to hatch two dragons at once if you're able to kind of line stuff up. So there are some meaningful choices to be made. But overall, the rules and what you're doing from turn to turn, it's very straightforward.
Yeah.
And that was really the designer's goal of making something that would be accessible to more casual play and for families. Because whether you're playing 2 through 5, it scales, and it'll be a 30-minute play regardless.
Yeah. I remember there was one thing I liked, where if you roll doubles, right, you get a third one.
That's right. If you manage
to, that's kind of where I would push my
luck. That's your push your luck. Do you need the resources? Are you really going to go for it?
I really want that water. I could push, try and roll that to get the other water.
Coin.
Coin. But coin is points.
But coin's points. So there's nothing bad.
Yeah.
It's is the best thing there, or will you always get something of some kind.
Exactly. And that's what's great.
Yeah.
So that's a perfect family game. Art is wonderful. Everything is very whimsical and fun.
It's super unique. Carl, the designer, keeps telling me the story. It's adorable. The artist would have an art school, a teacher that would say, you're not going to be able to make money off of dragons. Like, it's just, it's not a thing.
Aww.
So when Carl was like, I'm looking for someone for dragons, she was like,
I got an idea.
I got you.
Yes.
So it's been really fun. It's a very whimsical, as you say.
Yeah.
It's a very different kind of dragon style. We really think it pops. It's been doing well over the booth. We've been very happy to see people.
So that's available.
It is available at the booth right now if you are at Gen Con.
Nice.
We do have a few extra goodies if you're picking it up at the show. But otherwise, if you're not able to be at Gen Con this year, it will be available at the end of August in your friendly local
game store. Coming up in a couple weeks.
Pretty soon.
You'll be able to get that.
Yeah, so it will be available everywhere.
Well, thank you so much, Colin.
Thank you so much for having us.